Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's first news for Friday, October 27th. It's made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. We have two more days of really nice, warm weather. Then our chief meteorologist, Dan Zarrow, says things are going to change. Now for today, temperatures certainly into the 70s, maybe 80. A sprinkle is possible. There will be some clouds overhead. Warmer still tomorrow. Saturday with 80s in many parts of the Garden State. And then on Sunday, the cool down starts. Dan will have all of the forecast details for you on air, online at nj1015.com, and on our free mobile app. In a surprise reversal, Governor Phil Murphy says toll hikes will not be going into effect on the Turnpike and Parkway in January. Murphy has vetoed what would have been the fourth toll increase in 3 years. During an appearance on News 12, he said the decision was not an easy call, but it was the right call. Murphy faced bipartisan pressure to reject the toll hikes, which would have supported a $100 million budget increase at the Turnpike, which the authority says would have added dozens of new employees. Meanwhile, New York City is gearing up to defend its congestion pricing plan, scheduled to go into effect in the spring. New Jersey is suing the Big Apple to stop it. Jersey commuters could be forced to pay thousands more to enter Manhattan below 60th Street. New York has hired high-profile attorney Roberta Kaplan to defend. She is best known for cases that granted same-sex marriage rights and an abuse and defamation case against Donald Trump. One of New Jersey's deadliest and dangerous roads is going to be closed later this morning. Patterson Plank Road in Jersey City will be shut down around 10 a.m. so police can complete an investigation into a deadly head-on crash that took place last Monday. At least five people have been killed in crashes along that road. The latest accident on Monday involved two cars and three people were killed. Patterson Plank Road should be reopened around lunchtime. Meanwhile, motorists frustrated by clogged Route 1 in South Brunswick have some relief on the way. Local officials say the state's Department of Transportation has authorized the use of the outside lanes for motorists during peak travel times. A six-month trial period will include the shoulder lanes beginning at Aaron Road in North Brunswick and up to Route 522 in South Brunswick. Final designs are expected to be submitted by the end of the year. Shocked and fearful, residents in Maine are spending another morning huddled in their homes. The lockdown as hundreds of police and FBI agents search for Robert Card, a U.S. Army reservist. Authorities say fatally shot 18 people at a bowling alley and a bar. Wednesday's attack in Lewiston, the worst mass killing in that state's history. On Thursday, heavily armed police surrounded a home in rural Bowdoin as they searched for Card, but they left hours later after searching the residence. Full details and expanded coverage on this morning and the manhunt at nj1015.com. The Pentagon is confirming that U.S. airstrikes hit targets at two locations in eastern Syria early this morning. Linked to Iran's Revolutionary Guard Corps, the strikes come in retaliation for a slew of drone and missile attacks against U.S. bases and personnel in the region that began early last week. They are reflecting the Biden administration's determination to maintain a delicate balance. The U.S. wants to hit Iranian-backed groups suspected of targeting the U.S. as strongly as possible, while also working to avoid provoking a wider conflict. Israeli forces once again made an incursion into Gaza overnight. The military said it struck targets on the outskirts of Gaza City as it prepares for a widely expected full-scale ground offensive. The Palestinian death toll has now soared past 7,000 as Israel carries out waves of devastating airstrikes in response to the bloody Hamas incursion of southern Israel on October 7th. A retired doctor from Elizabeth, already convicted of child pornography, is now accused of molesting a child 8 years ago. Neil Rosenstein, just days from turning 79, charged with endangering the welfare of a child, aggravated criminal sexual contact, and criminal sexual contact. In 2008, Rosenstein pleaded guilty to possession of child pornography and was sentenced to 51 months in federal prison. Last night, I hosted a special town hall broadcast on New Jersey's energy master plan and what it means to you as the state pushes to convert to more electric power. One of the biggest hurdles is New Jersey's electric grid, which delivers power to homes and businesses, and it's just not ready. It can't handle current demand and surely won't be able to handle the projected increase if everybody is forced to go electric. You can see a full replay at NJ1015.com and right here on our Facebook page. Plus, check out the recipe for the Halloween cocktail you didn't even know that you needed. It is my recipe for the candy corn martini. Whether you're hosting a Halloween party or looking for something to sip while you're handing out candy to the kids, I'll show you how to make your own infused vodka for this cocktail. That's also at NJ1015.com this morning. Have something to say about our top stories? We love reading your comments. Just leave them right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we are always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Friday, October 27th. It's made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. Have a safe and a happy weekend.